I want to emphasize to you, we have people here of all beliefs and all backgrounds, and we all love each other, and we are all standing together for life and for freedom.
So our next speaker, please give a warm welcome to Arish Sahani,
who is a human rights activist and the senior vice president of the Indian American Intellectuals Forum. India, Israel, the U.S., we all stand together against Islamic jihad. Arish Sahani.
My dear brothers and sisters, what I'm going to tell you today will shock you. Why it will shock you? Because this is my personal story. This is not my story. This is the story of all Hindus living in India. My name is Arish Kumar Sahani. My family lives in Muslim minority area. Now that area is called Pakistan. My family lived in Pakistan with Muslims for many generations. All Muslims in India were once Hindus. Imagine all Muslims in India, Pakistan, and Bangladesh, what do you see them? They were once Hindus. They are all converts. My father told me never to trust these convert Muslims. Never to trust these convert Muslims. Why? Because India got divided in 1947 due to Muslims population who were not loyal to India. Their own motherland, their own birthplace, but the enemy who converted them forcefully. My father told me his own Muslim friend during partition came to kill him. That's the way Islam is. When a time comes, your own Muslim friend will come to kill you, and that's what the West doesn't understand. We in India have been living under Islamic rule for the last thousands of years, so we know what Islam is all about. So please listen to me. Hindus living in India are very peaceful and loving, tolerant people. Our forefathers gave shelter to all those who were persecuted by Islam. Jews were one of them. I have a lot of respect for Jews and land of Israel. I have a lot of respect for Jews and land of Israel, always fighting for survival. You will never see Jews and Hindus going out of the way to convert people to their own religion. Never. Jews and Hindus, never. God created us all different. He created different cultures, ways of life, and communities. But look, only Islam is a religion in the world who is fighting with everyone and within. That is the problem. Islam is fighting with everyone and within. World War I, World War II lasted a few years. But Islamic war is going on since last 1400 years. World War I is over. But Islamic war
no more.
It is shame. We and our leaders have not declared war against Islam yet. It's really shame that we are not declared war against Islam yet. What are you waiting for? For death? Or do you think they will change? Whom do you are fooling? They will never change. Islam is not a religion. It's a political ideology to destroy all others who do not agree with that. When Islam is very clear about this war, than what we are waiting for. This waiting is costing the world a lot. Today we have 1.3 billion local convert to Islam who daily go to Saudis many times a day, read their one book of hate and killing infidels. Why our leaders do not understand this? Today people who are going to Saudis, can you trust them? I don't. Who are not Muslim, they have right to leave.
garden of the God with equal rights. But wherever a Muslim majority exists, there is no peace at all. Wherever Muslim majority is there, there is no peace at all. All others live there like a hell. We are being fooled by media. We are being fooled by media and intellectuals by the world like Taliban, Al-Qaeda, ISIS, Muslim Brotherhood, Shia, Sunni. One day they will use one word, next day they will use another word, and so on. But for me, all are Muslim first. All are Muslim first. And whenever they get charged, they will try to kill me, as I do not read their book, I will believe in their life.
No more! No more! No more! No more! No more!
I appeal to the world and United Nations, it's time this war of Islam should be understood by all who want to live and find a way to stop this undeclared war on us. I find all Muslims living next to you, our Farah is a real threat to our lives. All living next to you, our Farah, are real threat to our lives. These masjids and mullahs are their fortress and war commanders, and terrorists are breeding jihad, jihadis to enforce Sharia law. Masjids are breeding ground of jihadis. Jihadis are all Muslim. You never see majority Muslim criticizing Islam or its followers or Islamic action of jihadis anywhere in the world. Islamic terror, rather each terror get renamed as Islamophobia by media, a death of innocence. This is a shame. Big question, can we win this undeclared war of Islam against humanity? Their war plan is simple and foolproof. They convert our locals and make them kill us. That's the way they are doing for centuries. They convert our locals which are next door and make them kill us. We have to stop this. As said by a Muslim thinker, listen to this very carefully. As said by a Muslim thinker, where your government will put its bomb, put its own bomb, when from each street corner from New York City, you'll find a call by local Muslim, Allahu Akbar. This is a real threat. This is a real threat. The clergies are converting our poor and uneducated masses to Islam to fight and kill the local non-converts. This formula is going on the last 1400 years. Why our leaders are getting fooled? I have a last thing to say. Unlimited tolerance must lead to disappearance of the tolerance. Unlimited tolerance will lead to disappearance of the tolerance. If you extend unlimited tolerance even to those who are intolerant, if we are not prepared to defend a tolerant society like Israel and Hindu against the onslaught of intolerant Muslims, then the tolerance will be destroyed and tolerance with them. So let's fight the intolerant Islamic Jihad. Jai Hind! Long live Israel! Long live freedom!
Israel and United States of America. If we save these two countries, we will save the whole world. God bless. No more radical people. No